you guys, it's your girl T. So I want to come on here and talk about the whole R. Kelly situation, honey. So anyways, a lot of folks want to know my opinion on the whole Huffington Post interview that he did with Caroline Terraney. This whole situation is crazy. But let me go ahead and be the first to say this. Now, if you guys remember, I was live tweeting during the Soul Train Awards, and a few people had the nerve to get offended at me, honey. But I kind of called R. Kelly out during that time. You know, while I love R. Kelly's music, and I think he's a musical genius, I do find it funny that just because he's a musical genius and he's soulful, a lot of people want to ignore the fact that he was pissing on that 14-year-old girl. I said this tweet over a month ago, and it's funny now because that dialogue has been sparked back up. So what happened is that basically went to go do an interview with the Huffington Post, and I will admit, Carolyn was being very, very messy and being very antagonistic. At the end of the day, he was there to promote his music. She could have basically stuck to that, but she kept trying to poke and pry about the child molestation charges and reading tweets saying that people can't support him, you know, because he raped that girl, he peed on that girl, he was having sex with underage girls and they don't feel right. And R. Kelly was trying to hold his composure. You know, he went off on her. He even said fuck that at one point in time. The interview was 17 minutes long, but it's a really uncomfortable interview to watch. I mean, R. Kelly is sweating like a hoe in church, okay? It's like you can tell he's very uncomfortable with these questions. He does not want to answer them. He does not want to be bothered. You can tell he's really, really upset, but he's trying to hold his composure. Eventually, he walks out talking about he's about to go to McDonald's, gonna get his ass a McRib. So the whole situation is a hot damn mess, but you know Black Twitter has something to say about the situation, honey. So go ahead and grab your teacups and let's go ahead and check out these memes, comments, and what folks have to say. So you guys just saw all the comments, the memes, and what folks had to say. And like I said, the whole situation is a mess, but I don't really feel bad for R. Kelly. You know, I do feel like a lot of people make excuses for him just for the fact that he's a good artist, you know. I will never take that away from him. I still listen to his music till this day. He has good music. But at the end of the day, we got to keep it real. He was sleeping with underage girls. That little girl was not the only one. People saw the video. You know, people can ignore it because it makes them feel better. But at the end of the day, he was found not guilty. But I think that was more or less because of fame and money. I just find the whole situation kind of crazy that he would walk out. It almost makes him seem even more guilty that he was so upset and, you know, wanting to walk out as opposed to addressing it. I also feel like the interviewer was very messy and very disrespectful. You know, the whole situation is just real crazy, but it was really interesting to see him sweating and kind of, you know, feeling so uncomfortable and feeling really, really upset. But I think that he also should have been smarter. You do not go to a place to do an interview where it's based on ask R. Kelly questions and then assume naively that nobody's gonna bring that up. So I kind of blame him for putting himself in that situation because he could have did a totally different style interview where he refused to take questions from social media because, as anybody knows, honey, social media is super messy, especially Black Twitter. Everybody should know by now, social media, especially Black Twitter, has absolutely no chill whatsoever. Any and everybody can get it, point blank, period, including R. Kelly. So anyways, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire situation. How did you feel about R. Kelly being questioned like he was by Carolyn? And then how do you feel about R. Kelly eventually just getting up, getting upset, and running to McDonald's to go get a McRib? So let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. All right, deuces. Hey you guys, it's your girl T. Make sure to subscribe, like, and share my videos. You can also visit lovelyt.com to purchase any merchandise. Also, don't forget to click the boxes down below to watch any of my previous videos. Talk to y'all later. Deuces.